first group called Bernoulli's Principle. It's me, Paul, Sam Smith, Aiden Gooch, Carter Hedges, Lee Hayes, and Ben Puckett. Has anyone ever heard of Bernoulli's Principle?
No.
Well, if you haven't, Bernoulli's Principle is a physics principle. It states that an increase of speed in a fluid has a decrease of pressure in reverse. This is how planes fly. The speed below the wings is faster than the speed above them.
Has anyone ever heard of the ping pong ball and hair dryer trick?
Yes!
This works because the air going around the ping pong ball is moving very fast, which causes a decrease of pressure in the middle.
But Paul, don't you think we can show a little bit bigger?
I think we have something.
I'm Carter Hedges and I'm in the 7th grade.
This is the walking water experiment.
Hey Ben, how are we gonna make water walk?
The water will travel from each beaker into the empty beakers through the cellulose fibers found in plants.
These are the same fibers that are used to transfer the water from the roots and stem from the roots to the stem and leaves of the plant. And we are going to insert these paper towels or napkins into these beakers, and we will come back at the end of the show to see if our water has walked.
It moves fast, but not fast enough for them to stay up there.
By using the magnetic properties of static electricity. First, I need a volunteer to hold the cereal. You. By rubbing it into my hair. The electrons are moving from my hair to the balloon, giving a negative static charge. This might take me a few tries sometimes. So, I think you see how it's being attracted to it? This is happening because the protons in the cereal are being attracted to the negative charge of the balloon. But it only works once, because once they touch, the electrons from the balloon immediately jump from the balloon to the cereal. It's an easy experiment. You can do it at home. This takes a cereal, a piece of thread, and a balloon.
Volunteer. form is stored or potential energy. The comeback hand uses both forms.
When he rolls the comeback hand, he gives it kinetic energy, and the can begins to move away from him. One length of the rubber band has a hex nut. The hex nut is causing that length of the rubber band to not move. The other length of the rubber band is being twisted up due to the motion of the can rolling. When the rubber band is completely twisted up, the can stops. The can is not moving, but it has the potential to do so. When the rubber band begins to unwind, the can comes back to you. This is when the potential energy again transforms into kinetic energy.
Oh, exactly. Instead of exploding, the energy of matter lies inward.
Oh, come on.
Put the candle in the beaker and it go out.
dioxide left at the bottom of the tank?
No.
Yes. No chlorine carbon dioxide.
Oh my God.
Yeah, in the purple, right there. Can anyone tell me who Isaac Newton is?
No.
How about Rome? Rome, can you tell me who Isaac Newton is? Who? You don't know? Okay, who can tell me? He did do gravity. This is a non-Newtonic fluid. This means it does not apply to Isaac's laws of motion. Can anyone name one of his laws of motion? Yes, an object in motion stays in motion until it's acted upon by another force. This is a non-Newtonian fluid. This means when enough pressure is applied at a certain speed, the particles, instead of moving out of the way like we think they would, they realize, hey, we don't have enough time to move out of the way, so we're going to pack together instead. So they counteract. This causes the dude to become a temporary solid. Have I got Hope Tuesday here? All right, could you come up here for me? Science show, there was a group with a walking water experiment. I am about to do, Hope is about to do a walking on water experiment. So she's going to run across this hoop like this non-Newtonian fluid. And like I said, the particles are going to counteract and she's going to be able to run across it. Without sinking.
Thank you.
algorithms to solve it.
Sucks the egg into the beaker.
Matt Billy.
Good morning, the eighth grade.
Today we are going to be playing a balloon
with some pop-up. How does this work?
This is possible by lots of pressurized CO2 or carbon dioxide and soda.
Pop rocks are actually tiny pebbles of gas.
And soda is pressurized carbon dioxide.
And so when they're combined, the gas from the pop rocks is released going into the balloon,
causing the balloon to inflate. We will now perform our team.
Okay, now. American.
calcium chloride to create oxygen.
They're heating up the mixture that is a ratio of 7 to 10. They are collecting oxygen in these collecting bottles. And as we know, fire needs oxygen to burn. So we're going to light a stick and we're seeing how many times we can relight it with the oxygen we collected in the collecting bottles. Now, who do you think will win?
Me.
Curly headed guy. Me.
Thank you.
to the other beakers to form a solid
over time. Like on the paper towels, you see how the yellow slowly went over here, blue went to the empty one,
and the blue and red is over here.
This one would have made purple, and this one would have made green.
We're in the 8th grade.
Does anyone know what a vortex is?
Yes!
You make it a class.
When you tap the back, the vortex comes out the front.
The only problem is, y'all can't see it.
So, we brought a smoke machine so you can see it.
Thank you guys for being patient with us. I hope you enjoyed this science show.